In this video, we're going to talk about masks and how to create them. So oftentimes while you're sculpting, you'll find that there are certain areas of your sculpt that you really don't want to modify. What you would need to do would be to mask them so that tools don't affect them. You can do so in three different ways. You can switch your active tool to the masking brush, which allows you to mask areas. Masked areas will appear as dark areas within the mesh. You can unmask areas by pressing the alternate shortcut while attempting to apply masks. Another, faster way of using masks is by using the masking shortcut. You can access it on the sidebar at any time whilst you have a sculpting tool as the active tool. When you press it, you'll see that the active tool icon at the top changes temporarily to that of the masking brush. If I release it, it goes back to the standard. If I press it again, I'm going to start masking. I can invert this mask by pressing the masking shortcut and tapping outside of the mesh. And finally, another method is to use screen space area masking, which can be triggered by starting a drag outside of the mesh. A lasso line will appear. This lasso line allows you to select the screen space area, and as soon as you release it, everything inside the lasso will be masked. You can clear the mask by using the same approach, just drawing a little enough shape that doesn't cover any faces. If you have a mask and want to remove from it, you can press the alternate shortcut in addition to the masking shortcut and draw a shape. You'll see that the lasso has a different color, and as soon as you release it, this will clear the areas under the lasso from the mask. You can also blur the mask by pressing the masking shortcut and tapping on the mesh, or the alternate and the masking shortcut while tapping on the mesh to sharpen it. But there is another way of modifying your masks, which is by going to the mesh menu and tapping on the masking menu button, which has a few options. In addition to the ones that we've already seen before, there is also the ability to grow and shrink masks, and again, soften or sharpen. Finally, we've seen that the screen space area masking is currently using a lasso. This screen space area type can be changed by going to the bottom of the tool menu in Sculpting Context and choosing a different value. There are other basic shapes to choose from.